In Naxal affected districts, how the relationship should be between the collector, ASP, because both are crucial, one development, one fighting. Okay. So how the relationship should be, how is it?
In general, collector ASP relationship is like husband wife relationship at home. If we have a very good relation between the two, the home will be good. The same is for the district also. And when it comes to especially Naxal affected areas, the relationship should be much more better, as both of us require day-to-day help to function properly and also to take the administration to the grassroots people. So there should not be any miscommunication between the two. And the district administration especially should go one hand extra to provide all the support that will be required to the police forces who will be stationed in the deep jungles, like provision of drinking water, toilet facilities, barracks for the jawans, etc., etc. And many of these policemen leave their families in other parts of the state. So there also they will be facing many issues, like related to their lands, related to their admission of their school children, etc. We as collectors should go an extra hand to help to solve these issues, so that the men can concentrate on fighting against the Naxals.
Did you take any extra measures, whether there's periodic get-togethers between the collector, SP, DFO, like that?
So in districts like Bijapur and Dantewada, so since the number of officers are also very limited, and we have lots of paramilitary forces also stationed there, most of the times our meetings happen in a very informal way, outside the meeting hall, especially with the paramilitary commandants also. And also we meet very regularly, even for our morning exercises or for the evening parties also. So when compared to the rest of the districts, here the interaction between us are much more on a day-to-day basis, because of no other options other than this.
Now, since you are talking about paramilitary force also, because in Naxal affected districts, the CRPF camps are there. So how you establish relationship with them, and what is their role and what is the role of police?
So at the end of the day, SP is the head of the police in the district, and all the paramilitary forces which they come from outside work under the SP to fight the Naxals along with the state police forces and special armed forces of the state. So the paramilitary forces, when they come from outside, they just don't know about the terrain of the area, the culture of the area, etc. So the district administration and the district SP, they have to provide them the comfort zone so that they are able to settle down faster. And also they also develop a positive relationship with the district administration and have a good working relationship with us. And these paramilitary forces also, since they come from different parts of the country, they also need basic facilities at our locations. And also from the police point of view, even intelligence and other things will be required from the district police. So a good relationship between the commandant of the CRPF or the other paramilitary forces and the SP is very crucial in the joint fight against Naxals.
Now, in your career, you would have met some Naxals, definitely. Who are they? Actually, who are those Naxals? What they want? Why they become Naxals?
Though I have not formally met any Naxalites so far, as a general public, if they had come and interacted with me, so I am not aware about it. But when I joined the academy, so lots of guest lecturers used to come to take classes, especially on Naxalism and also development in tribal areas and Naxal affected areas, especially the Andhra Pradesh officers. They used to say that if you do very good job, the Naxalite will appreciate. Even some officers have showed that he or she has got certificates also from Naxalites about their good job in Andhra Pradesh. So I was also of the opinion that if I go and do good jobs, I'll also get good certificates also from them, but unfortunately nothing like that happened. But when I was CEO of Zilla Panchayat, I used to travel as I said, to Narayanpur district, which was part of Bastar at that time. So whenever I used to go deep inside and come back, the next day one person used to just come and say that, you just came to these places. It was very nice of you to come to these places. Thank you. And you'll just leave. I never knew why he came, why you said that, and why he left. But this used to happen at least 3-4 times when I went to those areas. So they were also keeping tab on my movement maybe. So it was that cordial relationship. But otherwise, generally, there never used to be much issues, but not any interaction with them. But sometimes when I go to very deep villages, which is generally out of police control, the first thing I used to do is to see the body language of the villagers and also the local staffs like health workers and Anganwadi workers. Their body language itself will show whether I should stay in that village for a long time or I should leave the village. Because sometimes if their movement is there and Naxalites are staying in that village, the people generally communicate that I should leave faster. So because of this, generally we never had any direct interaction with them. But sometimes I have seen them crossing the road. I have seen some shootings also. Even in my first year at Bastar, since I used to travel a lot, once I took many of the district level officers also with me. So there was a bomb blast also in front of our escort vehicle also. But that was not to kill anyone, but it was just to threaten that don't come to these area types. But other than this, there never used to be a direct interaction with them so far.
So for Naxal affected states, say Chhattisgarh, West Bengal, or Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, is there any special training given at Labasna?
We have Naxalite modules at Labasna where the officers who have worked in these areas, some public representatives, maybe sometimes who are involved with Naxal activities also, sometimes some NGOs also, they just come and keep their viewpoints and what they have done so far in these areas. Other than that, there is no specific training per se as what we should do or we should not do in those areas. It generally comes with experience and also interaction with your other colleagues and experiences of the previous officers who are posted there.
So who are these Naxals? Are they misguided youth or they want to, means whether they are going inside Naxalism because of poverty? What is the reality?
When we used to study for UPSC and also when we interact with very senior officers who are retired now, so Naxalites seem to have some ideology and they had risen especially to fight against inequality or exploitation. Way back in the country or certain parts of India, especially in the Andhra region. But my experience of almost 5 years in Bastar and 3.5 years in Sarguja, both are Naxal affected areas. At present, at least in Chhattisgarh side, I have not seen any ideology of helping the tribal people or any development in their mind. It is just more of an exploitation or a misguided youth where having a gun at your hand gives them more power in their village. That is what I have felt, because many of the developmental projects have been stalled by Naxalite movements. Even initially, when I tried to start developmental activities in certain places, the villagers used to say that, sir, you come now and at the most you can provide a security till 5 p.m. What will happen to us after 5 p.m. you leave? And also there are many developmental projects which we started and we have to stop. And I have also seen some of the very good sarpanchas who are proactive for development of the village have been massacred by the Naxalites. So at present, I don't know how much ideology they have, at least in Chhattisgarh side. But definitely, since many of this youth in this area doesn't have much job opportunities or livelihood opportunities, the having power of being a Naxal informer or even having a desi gun gives them more power and also a little bit of money in their villages.
And it is said that in some Naxal affected districts, the local government, say VAO or BDO level officers, they should pay some cut to them in different projects. Is it true?
Though I have never heard of any formal mechanism of any such percentage to be given, like what we hear in Northeast, I have not come across any of things like that. But we also listen a lot that the contractors, the minor forest produce collectors, etc., who come for trading, they pay some price. But I don't think any government staffs or any formal mechanism is there to provide any money for them.